Hey everyone, so this is part 7. In the last video, I just went over how to start setting up our API. So I've gone to binance.com, I've logged in, I've gone to my little profile, the top right hand side, and then I've clicked on API management. Okay, then I clicked create new API, I gave it a name. And now I sent a code to my email. I got the new code. And now I just need to enter my Google authentication code. Whoops, that's changing in a sec. So this is all that would have been set up on your phone just the first time that you set that up. So cool, there my API key is created. So I have my API key, and I'm going to go into my Octobot, and I'm going to go and paste that in there, and tick, and I need my secret then. So I'm going to go and grab that. There's my fancy face secret, and there's my secret, and paste that in there. Now I have both of those. What I always do is I check the first couple digits. So it's VI0, and that is, VL0, and it ends in 4TT, and it ends in 4TT, and then it's FA4 and KYY. FA4 and KYY. And that's just to make sure that I haven't accidentally copied not enough of the name itself. So what I will need to do is I want to enable margin, edit restrictions, top right hand corner. Then I want to, this API key allows from any API. No, not going to allow me. This option can be adjusted after the cross margin account transfer is completed. I'm not quite sure what that means. I am guessing that my existing bot that's using the other API is currently doing a margin trade. So what I do like to do is enable that margin just in case the bot does need to use it. I don't enable withdrawals from the bot so that if someone does get hold of my API key and my API secret, like you guys have it now, nothing's going to happen. Also, I'm going to delete this right off the video, so don't worry about that. So now what I've done is I have copied that in and I want to save and restart. This is still going to be trading in, simulated trading, and I can go and, after I refresh my page, it's going to ask me to log in again. Cool, I've hit remember on that, so there we go, and I am in. Now, I can hit trade in exchange sandbox. So, what it's going to do is it's going to do its best to trade what I currently have in the sandbox. So I need to restart that again. Okay, so it seems to still be offline. Let's just restart that again quick. Okay, log in. Cool, okay. So, trade in sandbox mode, and it is starting there, and it is simulated trading, so it's not real trading. It's going to be trading on the amounts that I gave it. When I set up the profile and I went to trading, it is going to be trading on this $50 and the 0.001 Bitcoin. So it's on the trading simulator. If I were to deactivate the trading simulator and enable the auto trader, I would